These are some of the teenagers who today began climbing the ladder to possible stardom. 300 lucky students picked from 1,000 applicants will be trained to be everything from a singer and dancer to stage technician at Croydon School for Performing Arts and Technology. It's not the same as the famous Fame Academy in New York, with which comparisons have been made, because students here are given a general education as well as courses about the entertainment industry.
Well, my mum saw it on the television when Richard Branson and Bruce were advertising it, and she said it would be a good idea for me to come here.
I like all of it because I like the way you can learn everything to do with theatre, to makeup and lighting, so I think that's good.
Well, hoping to learn about television, theatre and all sorts, but I like dancing as well.
It's cutesy and I have to say.
A rapper from Kidbrook in south-east London is among the students. 16-year-old Tatiana Mays, known as QT, already has a recording contract with EMI, one of the record companies who, together with the Department of Education, have funded a £7.5 million project.
I told EMI and like it was going, yeah, good, because like the sponsors to it. And I don't know, it's like the record stuff and plus learning about more about the music business is going to help me a lot in my future plans.
The students, mainly from South London boroughs, including Croydon, are from a variety of backgrounds. 25 teaching staff will make sure they get the sort of education which will enable them to choose between several aspects of the entertainment business.
If we have one or two future stars, we'll be delighted. But the students we've got here seem to me very promising in a range of ways.
QT is typical. Her talents aren't confined to rap. She is determined to eventually run her own record label. Mark Wadsworth, Thames News.
The ethnic minority known as the blacks. All of this stuff is real bad news, but you never get this when you tune in Thames News.